beautiful Virgo friends, and welcome to your horoscope for August of 2020, where I get to tell you happy birthday as we get to the second half of this month. So happy birthday, my Virgo friends. I know that the Leos were being very, very loud, but it's almost your turn as well. This is going to be a brilliant and a beautiful month for you. Not only is the sun coming into your sign, we've also got Mercury at the end of the month coming into your sign. So rulership, it's comfortable, it's lighting you up. And something else I got to tell you about this month, Virgo, that really speaks to me is the fact that Mercury at the beginning of the month actually moves into the energy of Leo, which lights up your 12th house space. And Uranus moves into Taurus, which lights up your 9th house space. Both of these positions for me with you, with the retrograde and also the 12th house spacing, let me know that this month, Virgo, you do not need to fight so hard. This is a month where, yes, it's almost birthday season, but you still get to kind of take it easy. You don't have to be the biggest, brightest thing in the room. You don't have to have all of the answers. It is really a month for you where I feel like you actually get the chance to take some downtime, do a little bit of evaluation of what you want for birthday time, but ultimately to really do some taking care of yourself as well, and giving yourself maybe the quiet time that you definitely need. Now this month we've also got the Eat and Greets continuing, and I'm really excited about all the guests that are coming. Glenn Mitchell will be here. We're going to have Kathy Rose. Kay Taylor will be here. Susan Miller will be here. Laura Nalbandian. Clarissa Dolphin is coming with vibrational astrology. So it is a good month of the people showing up at the Cyber House. So I hope that you will join me for all of that. As well, I will be at the summit for the Astrology of Power and Purpose, August 7th through the 9th. And I sure hope you will join me over there. It is free. So get signed up in the description box down below. But truly, if you need like a little mid-year pep up, or you're just excited to talk more astrology, this is the summit to come to. There's going to be just 17 different astrologers talking about how to interact with your astrology. I think it's going to be a really beautiful summit. Hope to see you there. And again, it's free. So come on over. All right. All right, at the beginning of the month here, Virgo, we've got a full moon happening in the energy of Aquarius, which is going to light up your sixth house space. Now, the sixth house is health, it's wellness, and I also include mental health and wellness in here as well. It is your daily routine, your schedule. It's also the service that you give and how you take care of other people. Now, the full moon says that something needs to be ended, acknowledged, or adjusted. So there needs to be a shift in your daily routine, something in your health, right? In Aquarian energy, one of the things I continue to think of is, where do you need to take or accept a little bit of unconventional behavior, right? Where can you have behavior that is maybe not your Virgo norm, but it's actually a little bit better for you, and it allows you to be more successful by bringing in a little bit of a twist to what it is that you're doing. I also think that at a social level, you may find yourself feeling like you want to pull back just a little bit with this full moon, where you're like, I don't want to be as social. I don't feel like I need to be as out. That could definitely be something that you're coming into. Plus, we still don't really know if the planet's going to fully open back up. So this could speak to that full moon happening up there as well. Now, on the 5th, we're going to see Mercury entering into that energy of Leo. Now, Mercury of the mind, one of your ruling planet, is going to be in the quietest space of your chart. So you want to express yourself. This is Leo, but I think in quiet ways, in ways of the spirit. I think maybe you want to work on something that's behind the scenes. It's not loud, proud, and just really big and in front of everyone. This is also a delicious place, Virgo, to go back, get into your own private space and take care of your mind. Take care of your thoughts. Take care of your spirituality. Where do you need space and quiet time to reconnect with what makes Virgo, Virgo? I think that this Mercury here is absolutely brilliant. Now, if you do have research to do, you're working on a project, a grant, you're getting some things in order, Mercury will definitely be in your favor in this particular house and position. On the 7th, we've got Venus moving into the energy of Cancer, so going to light up this 11th house space for you. This beautifies the friends. This magnetizes the friend zone. So again, this is not a month where you've got so much push. So maybe even friends are are gravitating towards you, right? Venus is great at drawing things to us. We don't always have to hustle where Venus is at. She'll magnetize and draw things to us. So you could find harmony with friends. You could find yourself feeling more social, but at your own house. Cancer, I want to be home, but I want to be social. The other thing I think Venus is beautiful for in this area for you is long-range planning of your finances, making sure that you're in harmony and balance in your relationships, especially in a long-range kind of way. This really brings a sense of harmony and beauty to the table. On the 15th, we see Uranus taking that retrograde in the energy of Taurus. This will light up your ninth house space. Now, Uranus's retrograde is going back. We're looking back. We're looking over this ninth house area, publishing, marketing, broadcasting, any place you've been looking to expand or you've just been expanding, but also your thoughts and your faith and your beliefs. Virgo, you are a mental sign. So as Uranus goes back in this area, he's going to go back over some beliefs you have, some ideas of faith, some ideas of what makes you tip top, what makes you really great at what you do, how you want to expand in the world, who you're going to expand in the world as, right? Now, as Uranus takes that retrograde here, he's going to put the pressure on you to say, I need to innovate in this area and I need to let go of some things because they are keeping me from my freedom. Now, I also think in the energy of Taurus, Uranus retrograde goes, Virgo, are you expanding financially too fast? Or keep an eye on your financial expansion. And that can be, are you spending too much too quickly? Or is it, or do you have a great plan in place, you know, for your college plan for your kids or whatever, right? Whatever it is, this Uranus retrograde is going to go back. It's brilliant. It's intuitive. There's a genius energy that says, what are you doing that might compromise our freedom here? So make sure you take a really good look at that, okay? On the 19th, we see the new moon happening in the energy of Leo. So again, giving some love to this 12th house. Plant your seeds of intention in a quiet space, in a quiet way, in a way that speaks to your creativity, that speaks to what you need to soothe your soul, but also really expresses who Virgo is. What do you need here? Plant your seeds of intention for a spiritual awakening that allows you to get up every day, Virgo, and know that you do work and you do something in this world that really has purpose behind it. That's a beautiful expression of this particular new moon. Now, on the 20th, we see Mercury moving into your sign. And then on the 22nd, we've got Happy Birthday, Virgo, because the sun moves into the energy of Virgo as well. So now we have light, heat, life, vitality. Your ruling planet is home and on par. Thinking and savvy. You've got communication skills. You've got analysis skills in your pocket and you are ready to organize. But more than anything, what I think you're really ready to do as the Sun and Mercury make their way over here is spend the next 30 days ready for this next version of Virgo that's going to be in place for the next year. Who have you become? Have you gotten prepared? Have you gotten organized? Do you have your tacos in order, Virgo, for this next version of yourself, for this next year? Because I really think that some of the secret to just true freedom, which we're going for this month, and true happiness really lies in some of the details. And I think at your birthday time, you're really well aware of that. And you also become aware with these two energies here where you can be of service to not only yourself, but of service to your community and the people around you in this next year. You're definitely stepping into, in some way, shape, or form in this next year, a service role. So make sure you're prepared and organized and just ready to go. And more than anything, enjoy it. It is your birthday time. Okay. All right, Virgo, I think it's going to be a good month. I think there are some questions to be answered. There is definitely some growth to be had as we move forward with these Leo energies that are on the table as well. I will tell you, if you're doing back to school stuff, those Leo energies may pique you to pay attention to what's happening in the daily routines of your children as well. So just kind of keep your eyes on that prize as well. All right. Like this video, comment, share, subscribe, and I will see you next month, Virgo. Bye, everyone.